Welcome. In this video, we'll talk about the fundamentals of an electrical system. In particular, we'll talk about certain circuit quantities. There are basically five major electrical quantities that we are interested in: charge, current, voltage, energy, and power. Among these five quantities, however, current, voltage, and power are typically used for circuit analysis. So let's quickly talk about some of these parameters. Charge. Well, in the physical world, there are two kinds of charges, positive and negative charges, and charges are measured in a unit called Coulomb. Charges are typically quantized, and a collection of charge is basically a multiple of 1.602 times 10 to the negative 19 Coulomb, which happens to be the smallest amount of charge that is present in an electron. Basically, when conservation of charge says that electrical charge can neither be created nor destroyed. Now, when a group of charge moves from one point to another, or a group of charge is forced to move around, it gives rise to what is known as electrical current. So electrical current is basically the measure of the rate of flow of electrical charge through a given point. So whenever we're talking about current, we are always talking about a flow of charge per unit time through an element. So here's an example of an element, and the current is flowing from direction A to direction B. The unit of current is amperes, or amp, or we simply abbreviate it as A. Current has both a polarity and a direction. So it has a both magnitude as well as the direction. So current can be, since it has a polarity, it can be either positive or negative. Basically, what a positive or a negative current basically means is a current flowing in a particular direction, and if it has a negative value, then it basically means that the current was actually supposed to be flowing the opposite, the other direction than what we had thought. So basically, we start out by picking an arbitrary direction for current, and if the sign of the current that's calculated or measured comes out to be negative, then really the current is flowing in the opposite direction. More on this when we talk about passive sign convention later. Now, the next thing that we want to talk about in terms of circuit quantities is called the voltage, or the electrical potential. The voltage is electrical potential between two points in space, and it's basically the amount of energy that is required to move 1 coulomb of charge from point A to a point B. The unit of voltage is joules per coulomb, and it's given as written as volt, or simply V. Whenever we calculate voltage, since it is the amount of energy that's needed to move a charge from point A to B, voltage is always written with respect to a particular reference point. So, for example, in this particular example, we have nodes A and B. A is at a particular potential, and B is at another potential, and the voltage is considered to be the difference between these potentials. So we write this as subscript V, subscript AB, which means VA and minus VV. So if I have an electrical element like this, and I use a multimeter to measure the voltage, which we'll be talking about more. So if we take a multimeter to measure the voltage, and the multimeter, let's say, reads negative 1.4. So the red is the positive part of the multimeter, and the black is going to the negative end of the multimeter, and we read negative 1.4. So what that basically means is the voltage difference between node A and B, VAB, is minus 1.4. And that's the same as saying that the voltage difference between nodes B and A, or in other words, VBA, which is VB minus VA, is positive 1.4. Okay, so it's basically a reference. Since a voltage is always defined as being between two points, it is useful to typically define a common voltage reference point, and in electrical circuit, that common voltage point is called ground. Just like when we measure the height of a mountain, typically the height of the mountain is measured with respect to a sea level. For example, the height of Mount Everest is 8,848 meters. But if you go to the base of Mount Everest, and take a measuring tape and measure to the top of the Mount Everest, it's not 8,848 meters. That height, the tip of the mountain, is measured with respect to a recognized reference point that's known as sea level. So we can measure and compare the height of two mountains, for example, Mount Everest, which is in Nepal, and Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa. So comparing two mountains in two different locations becomes easier because we have a common reference point for the height, which started at sea level. Similarly, comparing voltages between different nodes becomes easier if we can reference it to a single point, and we call that particular a reference point a ground. So ground has a voltage of 0 volts. So in our prior example, when we said VA, that basically meant we were looking at the voltage at node A with respect to a common node called ground somewhere. And when we said VB, we basically meant we were looking at reference node, we were looking at node B voltage with respect to a reference node ground somewhere else. Now, an important quantity is energy and power. Power is basically energy with over time, and it's given as a product of voltage times current. If we can expand, voltage was defined as dW over dQ, meaning amount of energy required to move charge from point A to point B, and current was defined as amount of charge per unit time. So that gives power equals voltage times current. So that's power, and the unit of power is known as watt. Now, in an electrical circuit, there are certain sources that provide voltage or current. Those sources are called ideal voltage sources. Circuit elements that maintain a fixed voltage across its terminal, regardless of the amount of current flowing in those terminals, so is known as an ideal voltage source. Now, example of a voltage source, a battery. Similarly, a current source is shown here. It's a circle with an arrow on it. It basically is a current source is a electrical component that is a that is able to provide current regardless of current to a load regardless of how much voltage is across those terminals. There are two types of current and voltage sources. One's called direct current. For example, direct current can be thought of something that doesn't change. A voltage produced by a 9.6 volt battery or a 1.5 volt battery or a car battery is an example of a direct current. It doesn't change. Whereas the voltage that we get in our electrical outlets fluctuates sinusoidally at 60 hertz, and it's called alternating current. So so voltage sources for DC voltage sources will basically use a circle with a plus minus and write the voltage value here. If we're explicitly showing batteries, this is the way to show it. AC or alternating current or the voltage that's available in the power outlets is generally shown as a circle with a sinusoidal source on it. Besides sources, there are because electrical components called loads, and here are examples of some loads: a resistor, which is pictured here, a capacitor pictured here with electrical schematics right here, shown as two parallel plates. That's what a capacitor is. Inductor shown here in a picture and here as a symbol. Inductor is basically a coil wrapped around a core, so that's what the symbol is showing. Switches. Normal switches we'll be using are either toggle switches, which you can go into high or low, or a push button switch. We might also be using simple loads called light emitting diodes, which are shown as such. So here's an example of a very simple circuit. A very simple circuit here has a source and a load, and sometimes has a switch in between. So this circuit has an open switch right now, so no current can flow through it. If I, however, close this circuit by pushing on this switch, so if I push on the switch and close the circuit is now complete. Current can flow from the voltage source, and the energy can be dissipated in the load, and the current can come back. So a complete circuit requires a loop to travel. It always has a source and a load.